on the instrument trolley for cystoscopy, you will have to have a few things that you need to check. You will need a lens. You can do mostly with 30 degree lens. But if your purpose is to examine the urethra more thoroughly, it is better that you use a 0 degree lens. But in practice, most of us use a 30 degree lens for all purpose, urethroscopy, cystoscopy and everything. Sometimes you need to examine the anterior part of the bladder, anterior wall just close to bladder neck, and for that purpose you may need to use sometimes a 70 degree lens. But in the video I'll show you how to examine that part of bladder with 30 degree lens only, and thus you need not have so many lenses in your armamentarium. So one is the lens. Second, you should be clear about the type of sheath that you are using. Normally you have three type of cystoscope sheaths, and you can see the number. One is the 17 French here, this is the 19 French sheath here, and this is the 22 French sheath here. In the French sheath, you'll also see written below the numbers. These numbers indicate what size of ureteral catheter can pass through the working channel when the cystoscope lens is in place. So you should know which sheath to use. If you are doing a urethrocystoscopy only for examination under local anesthesia, it is better that you use a 17 French sheath. But if you think you need to do a biopsy of the bladder, then you need to put in a biopsy forceps also through that, which should be ready on your trolley. This is the cold cup biopsy forceps. You can see the cups. See, that's how it opens and closes. So it's a cold cup biopsy forceps. Keep it ready. This will go only in the 19 French sheath or greater size of the sheath, not with the 17 French sheath. Okay, if you are contemplating to do a ureteral catheterization and a DJ stenting or something else, and then you should use a thicker sheath, 22 French sheath. Okay, so here I'll be using a 19 French sheath in this patient. Then this is the bridge, a connecting bridge, and I'll show you how to connect the bridge when I tell you how to assemble the lens. You will need a jalocaine jelly for lubrication, and this is 4% jalocaine to anesthetize the urethra. You should also have ready a meatus calibrator. Sometimes meatus is narrow, and to allow the atraumatic entry of cystoscope inside, you have to calibrate the urethra. And then the set of tubings. This is irrigation inflow set, and this is irrigation outflow set. You should also keep a couple of pads and gauze pieces on table. And also good idea to have, you know, a culture sample bottle. Sometimes you need to collect a sample of urinary culture in the procedure. So that's about the instrument trolley. Let's move to the patient. Let's see how to assemble the cystoscope. And I have certain points which are important. This is the cystoscope sheath. First, you take this bridge, and you have to apply this bridge here. In the bridge, there is a zero here, and in this cystoscope sheath also there is a zero here, and you have to connect zero to zero, and then you rotate. This will lock. It is important that you lock it properly, right? Now next, you put in the lens in this sheath. This is the 30 degree lens. Now when you are going to introduce lens, keep this thumb here and let the tip of the lens rest on the thumb. If you don't have the thumb and you just put it in, you are wobbling and you may hit the tip of the lens with the back of the bridge and traumatize your lens. And if you have a thumb here, rest it here, and then you gently advance a stable scope into the bridge. Now sometimes, because of excessive use, there is some band here and you may encounter some resistance while you are introducing the lens. So be careful. If there is resistance, don't push it. Otherwise, gently, this will automatically go. Now, as you come at the back end, you will see a cut here on the cystoscope, and you see a slit here on the bridge. You can see here. So you have to align this slit with this slit here, and the cystoscope slit into this. Then they fit with each other, and then you lock this. It is very important that you lock it properly. Otherwise, the cystoscope may disassemble in middle of the procedure and then create a lot of confusion. So it is vital, therefore, to lock properly the bridge to the sheath and a scope to the bridge. Having done so, this is the light source which you have to connect at this point. Now before you connect light source, you examine, is there any dirt here? If there's a dirt here, you may have to clean this with the gauze piece. Don't have any dirt here, don't have any stain here. Clean this area well. And not only this area, examine the eyepiece. Clean this well. Tip. Clean this well. There should be no stain or dirt or anything here. And put this light source here. Okay. Then you connect the camera. Now before you couple the camera with the scope, you must make sure there's no water here and there's no water here. If there's a water, you clean it. Because if there's a water film in between, your image will be blurred. And then you have to rotate, couple it here and leave it. And ensure that they are nicely fitted in. Now when you have this lens fitted in, now once you have assembled the lens, light source and camera, then you should do what's called white balancing. For white balancing, you have to use a flat white surface, gauze piece, or better still, to have something which is more flat, clean and white, put the lens over it and press the white balance. And next, you connect the irrigation lines. This is the inflow, water inflow. It is closed here, you open it later. And then you connect the outflow pipe. Outflow pipe is connected here. And then this tube should be allowed to drop down into the funnel. Now, before you start putting in cystoscope, it is very important that you open this channel and let the irrigation flow should flow through this. Now this will serve two purposes. One, it will flush the cystoscope sheath of all the chemical liquid. As you know, we sterilize these lenses and sheaths with chemical liquid. And if you take it out, even if you wash it properly, some chemical liquid can remain inside. So you connect the irrigation connection, switch it on and let it flow for a while so that it is flushed out. The second purpose it does is that the air bubbles are eliminated from the lumen of the sheath and then they will not go in the urinary passage. So before you start introducing the scope in, flush this channel. Now we have spent about good 7 minutes and this liquid, gelatin liquid has stayed inside. In this time I am sure this urethral passage is nicely anesthetized. And we will now introduce our cystoscope sheath into urethra.